February 18, 1:04 p.m. Okay. Gordon freaked out. Once we were sure Emily was in a good condition, we set off. It wasn't too damaged, only a missing buffer. We passed through Kronk and noticed a small trail of blood. Heise told this to James, who said to be alert. Just outside Kildane, James ordered us to stop. The smell of blood was horrible, but we didn't stop for that. We heard two people talking. By two, Oliver spoke up saying it could be Trevor, and the other wasn't Toby. Edward and Heise looked at each other. I opened the regulator, and we went into the yard. Just to find Oliver was right. Toby was long dead, his face had been torn away, taking everything from inside his bell side rods, wheels, and a lamp iron. We also noticed Trevor talking with someone. Slowly, the engine got out of the shed. His green paint was covered in dust. But the number 3 explained everything. We examined Henry. Jem Cole said he's fine. We began wondering how Henry was even here. Until Oliver chirped up again saying he knew the reason. And looked at Toby's remains. There was a long silence before James smiled and said those fateful words. Apparently, the eclipse reached the other railway. Spencer and Flying Scotsman were helping evacuating Barrow and Furnace. Scotsman decided to check solder. The controller agreed, and he left. Passing the Vickerstown Rolling Bridge, old slow coach attacked him. He escaped her, and saw two black tank engines. He guessed he saw the Scottish twins Duck, Arthur, Bertie and Neville with them, but in Vickerstown Yard. He had the same shit, but with Thomas and Percy at Croven's Gate. He hid at Kelstrope when he found Diesel. He claimed he saw Gordon passed, heading to Croven's Gate. Not long after, Edward Oliver and Toad arrived. We spoke to Sir Topham about the engines. One was an LMS Class 3F named Ginty and the other an LMS Kitson 0F named Pug. Scotsman said they looked unharmed, so the eclipse didn't got them.